With complete absence of fluid around the fetus, sonographic assessment is not as precise.
Part of the procedure many times is to expand the amniotic space, and that's called an amnioinfusion, where we actually put fluid into the amniotic space to create enough of a fluid pocket to allow us to do this deployment of the shunt.
You picture a completely deflated football with your kid inside it, and him trying to stick a needle into the football without hitting the kid inside.
Because the baby had his fists up here by his face, there was a little spot over between his hand and his face where they could get that needle in. I think what amazed me most throughout the entire process was the amazing teamwork that took place between the ultrasound technician and the physician, whether for a bladder tap or the infusion or the actual shunt procedure.
To place a shunt, we do that in the operating room.
In utero, shunting is performed as an outpatient procedure in the SDU, which is our special delivery unit. Moms will arrive and will be prepped for the procedure, will receive anesthesia services.
The patient gets sedation and is comfortable through their IV. We use local anesthesia, so they're numb and they don't feel the procedure. The sedation that mother gets is transmitted across the placenta, so the baby does get some of that sedation as well. We numb the skin, we make a tiny 5-millimeter incision through the skin, and then we direct this needle that will eventually be used for passing the shunt through the maternal abdomen, through the wall of the uterus, and into the fluid space immediately next to the fetal abdomen. Once the tip of the needle is in appropriate position between the pubic bone and the umbilical cord, then has to be carefully inserted through the fetal abdomen and into the bladder. Once in the bladder will start to leak fluid around the needle, so you have to move swiftly, but you have to move very precisely. The shunt has to be loaded into that needle. The shunt itself comes in the double pigtail configuration.
So there's a curlicue end on the outside of the abdominal wall and one on the inside of the bladder.
It has to carefully be straightened out so that it can be passed into the needle. It's a plastic that has memory, and so it will recoil to its original configuration. Once you're outside the fetal abdomen, you now have to again pull the sheath back a bit, turn it at an angle away from the fetus, and then push the other pigtail out into the amniotic space. So the hope is that it will lie flat against the fetal abdomen. After the shunt is placed, the mom comes out to her room on the special delivery unit where we watch her for usually about 8 hours. She gets antibiotics before the procedure. She'll get an additional dose of antibiotics after the procedure. We usually have them return 5 to 7 days after the shunt is placed to look at shunt placement.
To make certain that the shunt is functioning, to make certain that the bladder is decompressed, making sure that the amniotic fluid volume is in the normal range so that the kidneys can develop and the lungs can develop.
Once the family has come back for a post-procedure checkup and there are no complications, we start discharge planning.